Welcome to ESPN's Feast Week, presented by Lowe's.
The beach, the sun, and the beautiful Pacific Ocean, all quite alluring on the island of Maui. But the fans have managed the short trek from the beach to see two great semifinal matchups today at the EA Sports Maui Invitational. There is no questioning the strength of these four teams. First up, Kemba Walker, who literally carried UConn to victory with 31 points yesterday against Wichita State. He and the Huskies will battle Kalen Lucas and the second-ranked Michigan State Spartans. Week continues from Paradise. It's presented by Lowe's. From the Lahaina Civic Center, semifinal action from the 2010 EA Sports Maui Invitational, the Connecticut Huskies and number two Michigan State. Connecticut survived Wichita State yesterday to earn the day with Michigan State. In our semifinals today, we'll see three of the top 11 teams in the country. Later tonight, it's number 9 Kentucky and number 11 Washington. Aloha, everyone. Welcome back to Maui. Sean McDonough along with Jay Billis and Bill Raftery. Delighted to have you with us. Speaking with Tom Izzo, the Michigan State coach, just before the game, he said there are some great guards in this tournament, and we're going to see two of the best in the country in this game.
No question. And it starts off for Michigan State with defense and rebounding. And the guy they have to defend more than any other is Kemba Walker. Kemba Walker of Connecticut is averaging 30 points per game. Tremendous quickness. He has tightened up his shooting stroke. He has really become a great guard. And instead of Star Watch, it's going to be Kemba Watch. Michigan State has to have six eyes on Kemba Walker all the time. A primary defender and two help defenders protecting that elbow and block to keep him out of the lane. And he's taken twice as many shots as the next shooter on this Connecticut team, Jeremy Lamb. Kemba Walker is a gigantic part of this offense for Connecticut.
And a gigantic part of the Michigan State team is the preseason Big Ten Player of the Year, another great guard, Kalen Lucas.
Well, the two eyes that are going to start on Kemba are Kalen Lucas. He's a sound defender, but more importantly, he's got to penetrate. They do a great job getting the high ball screen for him. He's got a middle game and certainly can step out and make the three. Great in the open floor. He's got a tough assignment defensively. He may have to concentrate a little more than normal on Kemba Walker.
And let's take a look at today's starting lineups. For Connecticut, Walker with the freshman Jeremy Lamb in the backcourt. The product of Germany, Niels Giffey, Alex Oriaki, and Charles Okwandu up front. The Huskies 3-0 after their win against Wichita State yesterday. Michigan State's also 3-0. Lucas with Jarrell Summers in the backcourt, Austin Thornton, Delvon Rowe, and Garrick Sherman, the front court for Coach Izzo. Draymond Green had been starting, but he'll come off the bench for Michigan State today. Jim Calhoun, in his 25th season as head coach at the University of Connecticut, he's won two national championships. Longtime assistant George Blaney alongside, and Andre LaFleur settles in. And Tom Izzo has a national championship of his own in his 16th season. Now the winningest coach in Michigan State history, moved past his mentor and great friend Judd Heathcote to become number one all-time in wins in East Lansing. And these two teams know each other. Last time they met, it was at the Final Four in 2009 in Detroit, a game won by Michigan State. Tim Higgins, Ed Hightower, Tony Padilla are the officials. Hightower threw it in the air, and Michigan State controlled the tip.
Sean McDonough, Jay Billis. UConn goes, wait a minute.
And the first shot of the game out of the corner from Austin Thornton. And out of bounds it goes over to Connecticut.
Rebounded, Jay, right? So essential if you're UConn, I think, in this game.
No question. And much more aggressive to the glass was Michigan State on that first shot. Delvon Rowe coming in from the weak side, going after it with two hands. Michigan State was out-rebounded by Chaminade. Don't think that didn't catch the attention of Tom Izzo.
Inside they go, and a turnaround shot wouldn't drop for Charles Okwandu. Thornton thought about another shot and then decided better of it. Now Lucas. Summers sends it inside. And a foul called in the post as Garrett Sherman went to make a move, and Charles Aquandu committed the first foul of the game.
Michigan State wonderfully getting the ball down the floor and reversing the ball. UConn is going to try and do the same thing at the other end. Go side to side and then attack.
Saw Connecticut's record at the EA Sports Maui Invitational. The last time they were here, it was a memorable victory in the championship game. Darrell Summers with the bucket,
and he's the guy. Darrell Summers has to have a big game. He's being guarded by a freshman, Jeremy Lamb. He only had 6 points against Chaminade. He's got to have a big game against UConn.
Giffey trying to answer for Connecticut. Lucas dribbled to the elbow, well off with the shot, and last touch by Delvon Rowe, so it goes back to Connecticut, trailing 2-0.
You lose a little rhythm. See how he bobbled that ball just before he shot? Just throws you off, jars you in the delivery.
I like this lineup change that Tom Izzo's made, starting Thornton at the three to be able to bring Draymond Green off the bench.
Oh, got to catch it. Great cross screen.
Moriaki could not catch it. Nice move in transition, and then Summers had a shot swatted away by Aquandu, the senior from Nigeria.
What a reaction. Oh, you got to run the floor. The big's going to have to dominate. What a drop step, spin. Say goodnight. Woo.
Lucas coming back from that Achilles injury suffered in the NCAA tournament last year. Calling the rebounding action. It's going against Thornton of Michigan State. Tom Izzo saying Lucas didn't do anything for about 6 months. And I talked to a couple NBA scouts guys before the game, so they were impressed with how nicely Lucas seems to have recovered. He's not back 100% to the explosiveness, but he's a long way there.
Awfully close, I think. Showed a lot yesterday. A tough assignment today staying with Walker, but he'll get a lot of help.
Jeremy Lamb. Connecticut still scoreless 2 minutes into the game.
And Kemba Walker has not gotten many touches.
Lucas again showing the speed to the bucket, but a wild left-handed layup stripped by Walker. Thornton and Walker collide, and Thornton's going to be called for a hip check at midcourt. The Spartan partisans don't like it, but it's a good call.
Well, at this high level of game, you got to come up with all the loose stuff. Great pursuit of the ball. You're right, Sean. Little cross check. Kemba trying to get on track a little bit. Work his way into this game. Hasn't forced the early.
Well, Thornton goes out with two fouls for the Spartans. Pitcher's duel here early. Still 2-0 Michigan State. Walker. Oriaki, and Connecticut is on the board. A bucket from Alex Oriaki, sophomore from Lowell, Massachusetts.
That's the kind of move that Oriaki needs to make. He just bowled his way to the basket.
Corey Lucius into the game for Michigan State. Summers was shut off by Giffey.
A nice trail on that stack screen.
Draymond Green just off the bench. Big Ten sixth man of the year last year, largely because that's what he does. Comes off the bench and gives them production.
And Oriaki stretching the D, just can't cover him deep.
Walker well defended by Lucius, who stayed right in front of Kemba.
And Lucas is right there to help.
Oriaki got his own rebound and dunks.
Wow, you don't see that very often. Draymond Green left early. He didn't go to rebound. I can't remember a time I've seen him do that. He just turned and ran out.
Nor a Michigan State guy do that.
One of the surprising things in that game was Chaminade yesterday for Michigan State. They were out-rebounded by the Silver Swords, 35-30. It's a Michigan State team that annually is right there at the top of the nation in rebounding margin. It's Green again. Draymond, couple of buckets. And a 6-4 lead for Sparty.
He's just a tough cover for a big.
Draymond Green's had back-to-back double-doubles for Michigan State coming in. Oriaki fouled. And he'll have a chance for the old-fashioned three-point play in the lead for Connecticut.
And Kemba's really playing relaxed basketball, not forcing the issue, turn the corner, and the ability to find people. And what I love about this kid, he rejoices for this pass. Everybody thinks he's just a scorer. He's a team player.
Now watch Draymond Green. After this shot, he just leaves. I mean, he's gone. And doesn't box out, doesn't put a body on Oriaki, and Oriaki winds up getting a dunk out of it. You just don't see that very often from Michigan State.
Foul on Sherman was his first. Oriaki way off. Adrian Payne has come into the ball game now for Michigan State, a freshman wearing number 5.
Nice slide to the box on a cross screen.
And Payne, wild shot, but it was kept alive with a nice tip out by Mike Keebler just in, and it led to a 3 for Corey Lucius.
I think Adrian Payne walked twice on that.
I think you're right.
Diffy, good catch, and that is... shot was taken off the glass by Adrian Payne, and it's a held ball.
There's Michigan State basketball. You got to match that effort.
Boy, first he walked, then he skywalked. How about that?
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you.
Well, Tom Izzo and the Michigan State Spartans have been here several times. So Coach Izzo has found the right balance. Let your players enjoy some of the experience over here over the weekend. They spent some time at the beach, went snorkeling, had a team snorkeling trip.
I think they volunteered to do that to you later if you're interested. Watch Adrian Payne coming off this little screen. When he catches it, he walks with it. See that extra little hop, but the offensive rebound. Mike Keebler keeps it alive, the extra pass. It goes for 3 points, and he may struggle a little bit on the ground, but not in the air. Adrian Payne, he caught that with two hands, caught the shot with two hands.
You know what's scary about Payne at the other end? You get free that easily. You're running some good offense. They just have to be patient.
Draymond Green went up for a blocked shot and committed a foul instead. Tom Izzo says that Adrian Payne is the most athletic big man that he's had at Michigan State. And he demonstrated that a moment ago. There's Jamal Coombs McDaniel just into the game, sophomore from Dorchester, Massachusetts.
I like the inflection when they're New England. You ever notice he really steps up his game, Sean? Coombs McDaniel's got to drive. He settles for that jumper. He's a better player, and that will come. Not shooting it very well from deep.
I was going to say, he's a good shooter, but he needs to start being a good maker.
Yeah.
Yeah, 3 for 14 for the season from the floor, entering today. Well, 1-point lead for Michigan State. 4.5 minutes gone by in the first semifinal here at the EA Sports Maui Invitational. Later on, number 9, Kentucky, number 11, Washington. Green trying to back in, well defended by Tyler Olander, a freshman into the game for Connecticut. Lucius the floater, then an air ball corralled by Coombs McDaniel.
A nice pinch here.
Nice job by Keebler to corral.
Mm-hmm.
Walker turned it over, Lucius. Bobby well, went to Keith Appling.
Tim Higgins was open.
Keebler lost it, fed it in. Payne couldn't rescue it. Both teams a little sloppy here. Sometimes second game in as many days, it can get a little ragged.
Well, that's a quick jack.
Over the back, foul called on Jeremy Lamb of Connecticut, his first.
No ball reversal, catch and shoot against a terrific rebounding team.
A lot of times a young team will do that. Keep it on one side of the floor, and you talked about it earlier, Bill. Get a ball reversal, second, sometimes third side. The best place to score can be the other side of the floor.
That was Jeremy Lamb that jacked it up, and he's on the Lamb. He didn't go to see Calhoun when he went out.
Shabazz Napier in, another freshman for Connecticut, considered an excellent on-ball defender. He's guarding Lucius in the half-court defense for Connecticut. A little too much pushing from behind by Olander. And a 6'9 freshman called for his first foul.
He'll learn to do that kind of bumping with his chest. When you do it with your chest, it's hardly ever called. You can usually commit mayhem with your chest as long as you keep your hands off him.
He did it a little late too, Jay. After he got the ball, he's got to chug him before.
Nice.
Appling open, missed a three. Summers came swooping in for a putback, and then his miss was grabbed by Olander. Now Napier.
Pretty.
Nice bounce pass and a foul. Roscoe Smith, the freshman, went up to the bucket and got hit. Wednesday night, it's a Hoops doubleheader on ESPN. The new Sunshine State rivalry continues. Miami and Orlando, coverage begins at 7 with key NBA countdown. Then at 10 p.m. Eastern, catch the conclusion of this EA Sports Maui Invitational. UConn or Michigan State against Kentucky or 11th-ranked Washington in the championship game. Part of Feast Week presented by Lowe's.
You like the puppies, the blue? The powder blue, little Carolina look. I love the big guys being alert because you're going to get a lot of dribble drive for big guys. They've got to get the hands ready. Nice dive by Roscoe.
Well, it's really tough to stay in front of these UConn guards, Napier and Kemba Walker. You have got to pick them up early and keep them out of the lane.
Lucas badgered by Walker.
Good call.
And a travel. The call from Tim Higgins. Second turnover for Michigan State. Yeah, that's a little bit
puppies, huh?
Off the standard issue.
I thought you were prancing on the sand today with those.
Walker. Coombs McDaniel.
Nice play by Walker.
Nice.
Oh, what a great fake and cut.
A terrific recovery by Summers. Helping out Lucas.
Whoops. Slippery floor. Coombs McDaniel went down. Napier rescued it. Oh, it looks like a disaster waiting to happen the entire time, and it is a Connecticut turnover.
I thought Walker should have shot that ball.
Yeah, he was a little too unselfish. And a good call by the refs. That double tick was tough to discern.
He's got a wide open three here. Just pull the trigger on it.
So Walker goes out. He had 29 points in the second half to lead them back against Wichita State yesterday. That's the most points in any half ever by a Connecticut player in school history. Broke the mark held by Richard Hamilton, who once had 28 and a half against Fairfield back in 1997. That came on the heels of a 42-point game against Vermont.
Ooh. Nice rebound.
And a foul. Well, he's Appling into the traffic.
These freshmen can sky. And Appling gets off the floor. Adrian Payne gets off the floor.
He's got some pogo sticks out of Pershing. Steve Smith's alma mater. Spencer Haywood, too, I think, Jay, if I'm not mistaken. Look at this elevation.
Good foul by Shabazz Napier. His first. He'll make Appling earn it from the free throw line. Keeps the freshman from Detroit. Pershing High School, the same high school that produced former Spartan All-American Steve Smith. Appling, 8 points in just 13 minutes.
The ball's wet. He wants to get the refs to wipe it off.
Well, that can happen. It gets a little bit humid in here. 85 degrees outside under sunny skies, not to rub it in for those of you in other parts of the country.
I'll bet he's played the rain before, though. What do you think? He's shot wet balls.
And that's what it looks like outside right now. Just a little taste of it for you folks back home.
I'm sure the snow is stopped. You still think it's nicer in Boston.
Oh, it's always nicer in Boston. The hub of the universe.
The pass was too late. He was open coming off the screen. Just a little flex cut, and he was open right under the basket. I think McDaniel needed to stop right off that screen in the middle of the lane and not come to the low block. You post your man, you don't post a spot. If he had stopped right here, that's where he was open. Instead, he went all the way to the block, and the pass was way too late and allowed the defense to catch up.
And he didn't like the call, but he was the last to touch it. Fourth turnover for Connecticut. 7 minutes gone by, a two-point lead for the number two team in the country.
Oh, nice play.
Appling and block. Great recovery on defense by Roscoe Smith, the freshman from Baltimore.
Terrific reaction, that late run-out screen, and this looks like an easy deuce. Woo! Great reaction. Elevation as well.
Talk about some players who can play above the rim.
Roscoe Smith out of Oak Hill Academy, perennial power in high school basketball. Of course, they've led the nation in blocks 8 of the last 9 years, but they don't have the one or two big shot blockers that they've had year in and year out during that stretch. Guys like Okafor and Josh Boone and Hashim Thabeet.
Hashim comes to mind, right? Hilton Armstrong, another, right, Sean? Those are some big kids.
1-4 set.
Summers.
Nice.
Jump shot a little too long from Kalen Lucas.
Well, they're getting open looks. They're just not banging him down. Well, a little wide pin down. Got a wide open shot for Kalen Lucas.
I think they got to go to the box just a little bit more, not settle though.
Wild shot. But it was retrieved by Oriaki. And then he was fouled. Got his own miss.
Oriaki had a drop step and a dunk after the double team. The bottom man on the trap split, just left. And all he had to do was drop step. And he watched. Delvon Rowe leaves, drop step, dunk. He just rushed it.
Well, if he was Blake Griffin, he wouldn't even need the drop step.
How about him?
Turn around and throw it.
That was incredible. He's 4 feet away from the rim.
He's not human.
Lamb, oh my goodness, what a tough shot, and he got it to go.
You know, the one thing Connecticut's not doing well, they're getting free, but they don't hold off well in the box area and beg for the ball, step to it.
But look how thin they are. I mean, aside from Oriaki, I'm not sure anybody's over 200 pounds.
Great anticipation by Walker, and he'll go in all alone. And UConn has the lead for the first time today.
UConn is playing older today than they did against Wichita State. They look young against the Shockers. Today they look a little bit older.
They had a rally to beat the Wichita State team that's picked to win the Missouri Valley this year.
Ooh.
Foul called. Lamb and the Huskies thought it was all ball, but Ed Hightower was standing right there, did not concur.
Well, you're anti-thin, but on the wing, they're pretty good. Denial. Smooth little play by Walker. Maybe get him started.
Check out the current Sports Movie Spectacular issue of ESPN the magazine for more on the next wave. Matthew Mitchell entering his fourth season as head coach of the Kentucky Lady Wildcats.
There was a nice recovery here by Jeremy Lamb, and there was no foul there at all. But it was just the swipe that made it look like it to the official. But that was all leather, all ball. And Jeremy Lamb is so long-armed, he can really affect shots, even though he was caught out of position after that shot fake.
And he's out like a lamb right now after a couple of fouls.
Yeah, I wish you were as meek as one.
Terrell Summers made the free throw.
You know, that's the tough part about coaching, though. You get a foul you don't deserve, you have to rest the player now pretty much the whole half.
Well, that's been Jim Calhoun's thing throughout the years. You get two fouls in the first half, you come out, and you stay out generally. That was the case yesterday with Kemba Walker, who played only 5 minutes in the first half after he picked up two fouls.
It was the case in the national semifinal in 2004 with Emeka Okafor. Worked out pretty well.
What a play there. Back screen pop, and the first time Michigan State not attentive to detail.
Kemba Walker with 5 points, and this is the largest lead now for Connecticut. Not expected to have a great season. They were picked 10th in the Big East in the preseason coaches poll. The travel against Draymond Green.
Well, so far, Michigan State has been a jump shooting team. You know, they're 4 for 16. They've taken good shots, but they've all been jump shots. And Connecticut has gotten the ball in the paint via penetration, some offensive rebounds. It's 10-2. Points in the paint advantage for UConn.
And a terrific job defensively thus far by UConn, Sean.
And Michigan State has shot the ball very well coming into today. 53% as a team, 48 from three in their 3-0 start. 5 turnovers now against Connecticut.
Much better D on Walker, but on this particular play, you can just see all of a sudden there's going to be a double screen at the end of this. And nobody switches out. Everybody looking for help. Summers gets caught behind and out of the nylon by the point guard.
You're not quite in midseason telestrator form at all there.
Yeah, a little shaky.
A little dizzy.
Happens when you go out late.
Green, air ball. And it's tracked down in the corner by Roscoe Smith. Off the fellow freshman Shabazz Napier from Randolph, Massachusetts, the beautiful Commonwealth of Massachusetts, the Bay State. Michigan State's now missed its last six shots.
Kemba Walker is just perpetual motion.
Tough shot by Napier. Whoa, can Summers get up there? Senior from Detroit, skied for the rebound. Lucius across to Lucas. Floater. Green in the right place. Payne had it blocked by Smith. Summers tried to dump it off for Green, who saved it in the corner. Steps away from a double and found Lucas.
Oh, how about the balance by the big fella?
Walker on the counterattack, goaltending. Both Payne and Green went up there to swat it. Uh-oh.
Oh, boy.
Walker is still down.
Tom Okoliak very nicely. The trainers, great fraternity they have. Michigan State's trainer.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, it is.
Looks like he's feeling a lot better now as he rolls over on his back.
Terrific step through. A lot of people talking about the Euro step. Ginobili, of course, of late. Barcelona's years ago. A very effective weapon. Crossover without the dribble.
Well, you mentioned the pro players, Bill, and Kemba Walker says he really benefited this summer. He helped prepare the United States team that was going over to play in the World Championships. The team comprised of pro players. There's another look at as he goes down hard after the goaltending call. So Kemba was practicing every day against some of the best players in the NBA, and he said he really had a renewed appreciation for how hard the best players play all the time.
Every play, yeah. And you felt he worked as hard as anybody this summer.
I agree. I mean, a lot of players work hard, but nobody worked harder than Kemba Walker did this summer. I know that for a fact. He was magnificent all summer long.
How would you know from every country club porch in America?
He looked at the tapes.
Yes, he was told by Kemba.
Give it to him.
Lucas, little hesitation move. Off to his good buddy Summers, who got kneed by Jamal Coombs McDaniel, and that's his first and the sixth on the team.
UConn is doing a lot of things really well defensively, but one thing they need to do a better job of is to close out under control. You know, you lift your eyebrows and they're leaving the floor.
Green. Just what did get it in, found a man wide open. It was Summers streaking down the lane.
What a cut by Summers. Really bailed his teammate out.
9-4 Durrell. 973 career points now, so he's on his way to becoming the 41st Spartan. Ooh. With 1,000 career points. Soriaki up and in for UConn.
Shabazz said, I used to get that call when I was younger. Napier, nice compliment. Walker can play off the ball when he comes back in.
Well, Napier, I think, is going to be really special on the defensive end. He's just got defensive instincts.
Look at that.
Teach.
Just as you said.
Lucas. Off for Lucius. Just did get away with the pass. Lucas open for three.
Well, you gamble against good teams, you pay for it. Overreact. And not balanced, similar to what you were saying about closing out.
Especially Green. For a big guy, just a terrific passer.
5 points for Kalen Lucas. He had 28 yesterday in their come-from-behind win over Chaminade. They trailed by 8 in the first half of that game. Summers deflected it out of bounds, and that'll get us to immediate timeout. Good to see Walker is feeling better and ready to check back in for UConn.
Send it back to Maui now, 2020.
All right, Carl, thank you. Michigan State and Ohio State, two of the five Big Ten teams in the top 20 in the country this week. A lot of people think they're the best conference in America this year. Kemba Walker, one of the best guards in the country. 7 points for Kemba.
Well, he hasn't forced anything. He's got, as you mentioned, 7 points. He's only taken four shots. But he has really run off a lot of screens, and he has made his defenders work, and you would think that that's going to open up some things from his teammates, but I'm not sure some of them are quite experienced enough to take advantage of it. But most of the points that UConn has put on the board have come in the paint.
You know, the way he's playing is going to set up his dribble drive game, too. All of a sudden, he relaxed defensively, think he's going to use screens, and he blows by with that mid-range game.
Neil Skippy plays it in to Shabazz Napier, freshman to freshman there.
Good help by Summers.
They do space well.
This young Connecticut team with three freshmen on the court. Shot clock at four, and Walker got a friendly bounce around the rim, off the glass, and back in.
They're like the old Garden Ribs the way it plays.
Well, it's not like Mike Keebler did a bad job there. He was right on him, made him take a tough shot, and he made it.
Keebler, a defensive specialist, getting some time early. He's guarded here by Kemba Walker.
Face up and drive.
Delvon Rowe working on the freshman Olander. Try to shovel it underneath to Sherman. Deflected out of bounds by UConn. 9 to shoot for the Spartans.
And Walker right there helping out, sliding. That was an easy basket if he didn't do that.
Rowe to play it in to Sherman with Lucius, Summers, and Keebler. Three to shoot. Lucius has to fire. And it rattled out. And a good rebound in traffic by Alex Oriaki. Olander, local product from Mansfield, Connecticut, right next to Storrs. Went to E.O. Smith High School in Storrs. Summers a tip out. Sherman on the floor with Olander. A held ball to go over to the Spartans.
Olander has some nice step moves. Didn't look as effective there, but really understands low post play.
What I liked was when he cleared space. You know, he was patient when he caught the ball in the post. He didn't make his move right away. He turned and looked and took his time.
Kalen Lucas back in. We talked about how the scouts were impressed by the explosiveness, quickness of Lucas. Not all the way back, but on the way back, certainly. And they wanted to see that when they came here to see him. And Tom Izzo thinks that lack of explosiveness really helped him in some ways, because he's had to work on his mid-range game because he just can't rely on blowing by people.
It helps his pace is what Tom thinks.
Taking his time.
Now. Yeah.
Not to shoot from mid-range there, and it got blocked.
Look at this.
Walker exploding to the bucket.
Wow.
That would be the opposite of taking your time.
Yeah. Oh, get the state police out after that car.
12 points for Kemba, and the largest lead for Connecticut.
Well, Michigan State has had to deal with some really fast guards lately.
Bennett, Stephen Bennett yesterday.
Yeah, Bennett from Chaminade, and then Bruce Ellington from South Carolina, who's a jet, and now Kemba Walker.
Sherman, nice up and under for the big fella. Derek Sherman, 6'11 sophomore from Kenton, Ohio.
He does that really well, doesn't he?
I just think you said it yesterday. He's very clever around the rim.
He gets it to the other side of the rim and protects against the shot block.
Nice help
by Sherman to step out on Walker. Giffey's open. Olander over the back, called for the foul as he went on top of Delvon Rowe.
How would you like to chase this vehicle, Jay?
0-60 in under 3 seconds.
Woo. Fortunately, it wasn't a toll road. That is some jet.
Now, how about the stretch that he's had? We mentioned 29 points in the second half yesterday, 31 for the game, on top of the 42-point game in Hartford against Vermont. 73 points in the previous two games, the most in a two-game span ever under Jim Calhoun.
Some great players. Ron Butler comes to mind. You mentioned Hamilton. But they have some guys who could fill it up, too. Danielle Marshall going back.
Yeah, 42 points ties the most ever for a UConn player under Jim Calhoun. Danielle Marshall and Cliff Robinson both have a 42-point game.
Now, you're a Boston guy. Did you ever imagine when he left Northeastern this was going to happen?
No, because Connecticut was way, way down at the bottom of the Big East. Hard to imagine. You know, Jim Boeheim, who got inducted into the Hall of Fame in the same class with Jim Calhoun, calls what Calhoun's done one of the great building jobs in the history of college basketball. Took it from nothing, basically, to a couple of national titles, 10 Big East championships. Roa block, and it wound up back with Roscoe Smith. Now Oriaki in traffic.
Get it out.
Oh, goodness.
Held ball, Connecticut ball.
Wow. Kalen Lucas was really in there battling, too. He was even doing it from down on the floor. Knocks that ball away, and he's still reaching for it, trying to get up.
He's trying to get a little lingerie.
The officials continue to change the basketballs from time to time because they are getting very slick. It's very warm in here today. Ordinarily, they have the air conditioning cranked up, but perhaps it's not working today because it's warm and humid, noticeably warmer than it was yesterday.
He complains about the weather. He complains about the building.
Billis was the one who said during the last TV timeout how hot it was in here. I'm simply echoing the words of my idol. Donnell Beverly into the ball game. Senior missed his first shot from the corner. Summers a deep three. And Giffey controlled. Now Beverly, senior from Los Angeles, seldom used in the last 3 years.
So he's got to run the show when he comes in. Don't look to be jacking him up.
Smith tried to jack it up. It was blocked by Delvon Rowe. Now runs with Summers. Summers blocked for the goaltend by Roscoe Smith.
I love Smith hustling back.
ESPN's the home court of college hoops, and Wednesday ESPN2 has both semifinal games from the Dick's Sporting Goods NIT season tip-off. It's 7 Eastern. VCU takes on number 24 Tennessee, then at 9 Ben Howland's UCLA Bruins take on Corey Fisher and 7th-ranked Villanova. The Dick's Sporting Goods NIT season tip-off, a big part of Feast Week, presented by Lowe's on ESPN2 Wednesday. Both games are also available online at ESPN3.com.
Boy, don't be surprised if VCU beats Tennessee. Rams are really good. Joey Rodriguez, an outstanding play. Hit 17 assists in a game earlier this year.
Oriaki lost it on the way up. UConn had a 5-point lead, but Michigan State has scored 6 unanswered. Walker, a little hop step there. He got called for a travel.
He got pushed into the walk, Jay. A legitimate beef, I think. If it is a walk, watch the shove now. That contact's enough to jar you.
I agree. Referees did a nice job of holding their whistles there because Tim Higgins put it in his mouth to blow a tee.
In the NBA, that would have been technical. Kalen Lucas showing that explosiveness as he comes back from the left Achilles injury suffered in their second round dramatic win in the NCAA tournament over Maryland.
Lack of concentration on D on that last trip by Connecticut. Fatigue could be a factor.
Napier, long three, wouldn't go. Batted around. Oriaki on the floor. Walker from the elbow. Oriaki again. Gets the roll. What work by Oriaki. He went down on the ground. Got it back out. Got out of the lane and then got back on the offensive glass.
A great save and, of course, the soft delivery. By Walker, set up the tip.
He's been a workhorse.
10 points for Oriaki. Lucas used the high screen from Draymond Green, but missed the layup. Walker trying to give Connecticut the lead again. He's fouled, and they'll call that in the act of shooting. 2 shots, the signal from Tony Padilla, but it'll be after immediate timeout.
Oriaki had the inside position, but kept working. Goes down on the floor and then back up.
Adrian Branch, Doug Gottlieb, I'm Carl Ravitch. Coming up on the UPS Halftime Report, Fran Fraschilla becomes the 4th member of our cast. The logistics of the game, we'll look at this Michigan State offense, a preview of the game between Kentucky and Washington, and why there's a little bad blood between the two. That's coming up at the half.
All right, Carl, thank you. Here in Maui, Alex Oriaki already a double-double for Connecticut. 10 points and 10 rebounds, and 8 of the 10 rebounds are at the offensive end.
He's just been outworking everybody. Goes after every rebound with both hands, uses his body. That was early on in the first half when Draymond Green didn't even go to the defensive glass and get a body on somebody. And Oriaki has been a man inside. And you know, Michigan State's been a jump shooting team.
Mm-hmm. They got to get somebody down low to ring the bell a little bit. Get to the free throw line, drive. You mentioned before when Rowe had the post up, didn't turn to be, wasn't a threat.
Yeah, he was pushed off the block against Olander and needed to face him up and get into the lane instead of trying to back him down.
So Kemba Walker with 12 points is at the free throw line. Ties it at 28, 3 minutes to go in the half. You mentioned the lack of punch inside for Michigan State, fellas, and they are a little short-handed up front. Derek Nix, sophomore center, 6'9", 270. He did not make the trip. Stayed back home in East Lansing dealing with personal issues. I asked Tom Izzo about that before the game. So, you know, a lot of times coaches say personal issues. Sometimes it can mean a lot of things. So literally, that's what it is, and they don't think it's major. They think they will get him back. But he feels like he's a little shorthanded out here in the front court without Nix.
You know, he could be a great asset. He's improved. He's lost weight.
Draymond Green, well guarded by Roscoe Smith. Tip wouldn't fall for Delvon Rowe.
And another jump shot that was contested. And usually Michigan State makes a much higher percentage of their jump shots. They're not going in today, but they don't really have much else that they're getting. They're certainly not getting to the free throw line because they're not attacking the rim.
Niels Giffey, nicely done. Pull up from just under the free throw line. First bucket for the freshman from Berlin, Germany.
He's got some talent, really understands the game. And Jay was talking to him the other day about his shooting, giving him a tip or two.
Jay was?
Yeah, it was good. Well received, too, by his coaches.
What was your tip?
Keep don't shooting.
Yeah. And I said, my tip to him was don't listen to Jay.
Lucius, the floater. And a whistle.
They call an offensive foul on that.
No, they're going to count the bucket and then the foul against Lucius.
Well, you got a 7-footer taking a charge on a guy 5'8". That's ridiculous. That's a bad call. That is a horrible call.
No, you don't think he was there?
He didn't knock him down. The guy just fell down.
You were complaining they're too thin earlier. They're not big, wide bodies. They don't have that center of gravity that you possessed.
You think that was a charge?
I do.
Okay.
But see, I would wipe the basket out.
Well, you'd already let it go.
I don't care. I wiped the basket out.
You changed the rule. I don't think that you should get a charge for just falling down. You should have to be knocked down.
Really?
This was incidental contact.
Now Sean is mad because he's not in this argument.
Well, please.
I think he was there.
Oh yeah, he really shot back like he was hit hard. He was barely touched.
I think you're both wrong. I agree with Bill. It was a charge. But, you know, I didn't know Bill was James Naismith over there making his own rules.
Well, I don't think you should award both teams for a play.
Mm-hmm. Lob! Oh! Short on the dunk was Summers. Lucius laid it up there and came down a little too low for Summers to get it over the rim. Wow. Then Napier from Honolulu. That was just in front of the Michigan State bench where Napier let it go.
He's got to think it over a little bit. He likes to get that jack. Just plays. He's a talented kid. This is where he excels.
Right, when you have when you try to spin on Napier, he does a great job of coming behind you and knocking that ball away. He did that against Vermont, got 5 steals.
Timeout, Michigan State. Sean McDonough, Jay Billis, James Naismith back in Maui.
I'd like to put you up there in that sky.
Parasailing, that's a lot of fun. Let's look at some day two storylines from the A Sports Maui Invitational. Wichita State, after losing yesterday to Connecticut, beat Chaminade earlier today behind 19 from David Kyle. So they'll play in the fifth place game against Virginia. An easy winner today over Oklahoma behind 27 points and 15 rebounds from Mike Scott, Virginia's best player. Summers a miss. Green and a goaltend on Oriaki.
And Sean, plaudits to Tony Bennett in Virginia to get off the deck the way they played. I mean, just to get his team organized and get to compete and forget the past. It's
and they got annihilated last night by Washington. And that was in the last game of the night, so they had a short turnaround time playing the second game today. That was one of the things that Tom Izzo was worried about today. Connecticut played in the first game yesterday at 10 o'clock in the morning. Michigan State played their game 6.5 hours later in a quick turnaround. Tom really thought there would be benefit to Connecticut for that extra 6.5 hours of rest. Walker a miss, and the rebound dribbled out by Green. He's fouled on the arm by Napier, and the Huskies better be careful. They're starting to be very demonstrative after just about every call now, and that isn't going to sit well with this officiating crew.
And Walker really played on that jumper.
Timeout called by Connecticut. 29 seconds to go in the half. Wednesday night, an appealing hoops doubleheader on ESPN. First, the Heat and the Magic. That's at 7 Eastern with key NBA countdown, and then at 10 Eastern, we'll have the dramatic, we hope, conclusion of the EA Sports Maui Invitational, the winner of this game against the winner of the game. Still to come at 9:30 Eastern time tonight. Number nine Kentucky and number 11 Washington. And I would say, based on what we saw last night, it's one game, but Washington is the most impressive team I've seen so far this year.
They can really get up and down the floor. I mean, three games averaging well over 100 points, but they're a better team this year than they were last year, and last year went to the Sweet 16.
Field goal percentage defense is going to be exceptional with the big guys swatting. I just love their man-to-man defense, and they can win and not shoot well. That's how good they play.
Kentucky right now the higher ranked team, but would you think that Washington with a veteran team against that young Kentucky team, Washington should be the favorite?
Yes,
I would. I really would. And it'll be interesting to see if Kentucky can dribble drive against this extraordinary defense. I think that's the key for them.
And whether Terrence Jones can continue his tear. He's the most impressive freshman I've seen this season. He and Jared Sullinger of Ohio State. Jones has been magnificent.
And that's one of the big stories we'll talk about in the second game. Draymond Green at the free throw line. Terrence Jones originally committed to the University of Washington, changed his mind, and went to Kentucky instead. He'll play for Kentucky against Washington tonight. Some of the NBA guys I talked to, scouts here before the game today, think that of all the players here, and there's a lot of talent among these eight teams, Terrence Jones of Kentucky is the best NBA prospect. Connecticut wants the final shot of the half. Down by three. They led for much of the half. They need a shot. They get it from Napier. A three at the buzzer to tie it up.
Look what I got. Walker stuck. What a bailout.
Really good defense. Just a great shot by Shabazz Napier.
First bucket for Napier. Kemba Walker again leading this young Connecticut team, the junior from New York City, with 14 points in the first half to lead all scorers, and he got helped by the Oriaki double-double. 34 pace at the half. Now the UPS halftime report. The EA Sports Maui Invitational semifinal action. Feast Week presented by Lowe's continues. Connecticut and Michigan State tied at 34. Later tonight, Kentucky and Washington. Welcome back to the Lahaina Civic Center. Sean McDonough with Jay Billis and Bill Raftery. Well, yesterday in Connecticut's win over Wichita State, it was just about a one-man show for Kemba Walker. Today, it's a two-man show. He's had a lot of help from Alex Oriaki.
And it's been all effort. Alex Oriaki's outworked everybody on the floor. He's got 10 rebounds in the first half, 8 of them on the offensive end, and he turned those 8 offensive rebounds into points. At 10 points in that first half, a double-double in just 20 minutes, and just quicker to the ball, very strong to the hoop. And 24 of the 34 points for UConn have been scored by Alex Oriaki and Kemba Walker.
And counted out with Michigan State unable to ring the bell inside with any consistency.
Walker and Oriaki, a combined 10 of 17 from the floor. And the rest of the team, 3 for 17. Rel Summers leads Michigan State with 8 points. Draymond Green also 8. Here's Summers now with 10. And the lead for the Spartans. Their largest lead in the first half was 3. UConn led by 5 at one point in the first half.
Now, Giffey went down there.
He was sliding by. Very effective weapon.
There was more contact there than on the one in the first half.
Tyler Olander, the free throw line, the fellow freshman Giffey, and another freshman, Jeremy Lamb, in for Oriaki. Foul on the rebounding action against Connecticut. If it's on Olander, it's his third.
Lamb was down there, too.
It is on Lamb, but that's his third.
It'll be interesting to see how Michigan State rebounds in this second half. Out-rebounded by Chaminade, also by South Carolina. Now that's something this Michigan State program values, out-rebounding opponents. And Tom Izzo wants his team to go after rebounds with both hands, and everybody goes to the glass on every possession.
They've led the nation in rebounding margin each of the last 2 years as Michigan State. Lucas loaded it up with Olander coming out to contest, and it'll go out of bounds to Connecticut.
Now they're going after it, JZ. Rowe climbing there. Two scripted plays right out of the half. That one, a side pick and roll. And the other one, a pin down.
Lucas refused that ball screen to take it baseline. Just couldn't make the floater.
Nice curl.
Olander from the elbow. Oriaki kept it alive and wound up tipping it in.
What a ball game. And that's one of those, they just slap it up and go chase it again.
And he isn't just doing it today. He came in averaging a double-double for the season through their first 3 games of the year. Wins at home against Stony Brook and Vermont, and then the victory out here yesterday against Wichita State.
And it's all effort. It's not like the ball's just bouncing his way. That was a big-time tip-in.
Austin Thornton handed it off to Kalen Lucas. Shot clock at 4. Thornton, tough shot, made it. Line drive from the baseline.
Great presence there. Defender on his right as well.
Foul called on Delvon Rowe. Or perhaps Thornton, he's there as well, and he seems to be most agitated by the call.
Number 3 on him, that's why his minutes will be limited.
Yeah, they were limited in the first half because of those 2 fouls. He played just 3 minutes.
I think Thornton is trying to make the case that it was Walker that created the contact. That's just smart basketball by Kemba Walker to seek out his body.
Thornton goes out with that third foul. Keith Appling comes back in.
Jim Calhoun, more animated boys, don't you think, today?
Than yesterday?
Yeah.
But he was very pleased with that win yesterday, don't you, Bill? Because he thinks Wichita State's a very good team.
Great confidence builder for this team.
You made the point at halftime as we were talking off the air. Connecticut's the 10th best team in the Big East, which is their preseason pick by the coaches. That's quite a lead. There are 9 Big East teams better than these guys.
Well, they are playing very well out of the gate against a terrific Michigan State team.
And if you had to pick the National Player of the Year through a very short part of the schedule, Kemba Walker might be your man. He was fouled there. Delvon Rose first.
I just love how he plays under control. And tonight is a graveyard this afternoon down here at this beautiful state. Just the pace of the game, let it come to him. Didn't force the issue. Ended up with 12 at the half, I believe, and solid.
Well, when it's there, he takes it, especially in transition. When it's not, he's worked off the ball. He's worked with the ball.
And taking advantage of the trips to the line yesterday, he was 14 out of 15 from the free throw line against Wichita State. Today, 5 for 5.
His efficiency has gone through the roof this season. He's really tightened up that shooting stroke. His shooting stroke is much more reliable this year.
As Napier trying to pester Lucas. Another 1-4 set for Michigan State. Having trouble getting into their offense here in the first 3 minutes of the second half. Lucas.
I don't think it was touched.
Yep, that's a good call. It was never touched by a Connecticut defender, Napier. And it's the sixth turnover against the Spartans.
I think the perimeter defense of UConn is so much better than last year.
I thought aggressive play. Yeah, you're right, it wasn't.
That's the kind of attorney you like, waffles.
I thought
I'm with you.
Such a good defender. I thought he got a piece of that.
Well, those are two words I've never heard Jay say. You're right.
Especially to you.
Exactly.
Tough shot.
Walker missed it. Rebound into the corner to Kalen Lucas. Swooping to the basket and a foul as Delvon Rowe scored.
Well, you got to go out and meet him. Take away that left hand, force him to go to the right on this break, but the pressure of pushing the ball on Michigan State, it's tough to get organized.
Looked like it was Walker going on the low side that got him.
Between two defenders, but giving it up early.
Well, they called the foul on Olander. Tough to see any contact on that replay. Third foul on Olander. And now Rowe. He's been battling knee problems ever since his senior year in high school and starting to get completely healthy. And Tom Izzo talks about people really just now starting to see everything that he's capable of. He was a prolific high school player at St. Edward in the Cleveland area.
He's so fundamentally sound.
Oh, yeah, he is blocked by Rowe. And the three at the other end for Darrell Summers. Timeout, Jim Calhoun.
Well, row, row, row your boat. The one end, the run out. This one, extraordinary D. And the ability to find his teammate. Knock it down. Looks a little stronger at that age.
Yeah. That's probably true of most players now.
He had 29 points yesterday. Moriaki, nice bend to the baseline, and he scored.
Big time. Little fake with the shoulder and that drop step.
He's bigger and stronger than Draymond Green, pulled his way to the basket.
And Giffey with a good post entry. That's something he does well.
Moriaki was on the Big East All-Rookie team last season, but averaged just 5 points, 6.5 rebounds a game. He's going to have much bigger numbers this year. Turnover gets us to another immediate timeout. It has been a very difficult year and a half for Jim Calhoun and the Connecticut basketball program, dating back to late March 2009, when a Yahoo Sports report suggested recruiting violations in the Connecticut program. Investigation that has gone on almost ever since found 8 major violations, and Connecticut decided to impose some sanctions on themselves: a 2-year probationary period, reduction of scholarships, reduction in the number of coaches making phone calls and days visiting prospective student athletes. It's been a tough time.
Yeah, it has.
Coach Calhoun. Really, that report service right before they went to the Final Four in 2009, and some of those Michigan State fans at Detroit were chanting cheater, cheater, cheater at the Connecticut folks, and that didn't sit very well, as you might imagine. Well, they're hoping that they're bouncing back from that. Unfortunately, a couple of staff members were made to walk the plank.
Well, there's Glenn Miller and Kevin Ollie coming on board to replace those two.
Yeah, good to see Kevin Ollie here. Just got into coaching after a 13-year NBA career. He's not on the bench today because he had a scary episode while stretching back practice in Connecticut with one of those big bands. The thing snapped at him right in the eye, and he's had some eye problems. But we're happy to tell you that he is getting better. Did travel over here with the team, but has been advised not to coach for a little while till the REI totally recovers.
Truly, truly great guy, too, Sean.
What a wonderful guy. Jim Calhoun says he really represents everything that they want a Connecticut player to be.
Well, got to get a hand up. That was a clean look.
Walker missed an open three that would have given Connecticut the lead.
Well, Shabazz Napier has really been a pest to Kalen Lucas. He's been all over.
As Kevin said, it was really a scary time for him. Talk about getting everything out of basketball. Great student athlete, NBA player, longevity, because he did exactly what the coaches asked.
And as good and classy a person as you'd ever want to meet.
Mm-hmm.
Played for 11 different NBA teams. He certainly wasn't the most talented player ever at UConn. As you said, Bill, he got everything out of what he had, and that continued long into the NBA.
Connecticut's defense has been outstanding.
Incredible.
May not get a shot off. Lucas had it blocked just as the shot clock was about to expire. Napier lost it. Came back to Walker, threw up a weird shot, and then Roscoe Smith was in the right place to tie it at 44.
I am so impressed with UConn's hustle. I mean, they have been feisty, and that's what you have to do when you play Michigan State. Match it.
Tell you what, they don't look young in this game. Ooh. They look a lot older than they did against Wichita State.
Nice pass. And the turnaround shot short by Delvon Rowe. Out ahead of the pack, Coombs McDaniel the dunk. And Connecticut leads again.
Giving it up early. All set up by Goodeep, but a great look for Rowe, though. He's got to make that.
Now Lucius, with Lucas playing off the ball. Summers, an open three off a Rowe screen. Tipped a couple of times, and Draymond Green scores.
We're seeing some outstanding offensive rebounders. Green and Oriaki just keep that ball alive so they can keep going after it.
Well, Green just carves out so much area with that bulk.
He'll wedge you down underneath.
Walker found Napier. And now Tim Higgins has a whistle. Apparently some bumping on the block. And it's going to go against Delvon Rowe.
Not a bad effort here, Jay, huh?
Delvon Rowe Draymond Green just keeping that ball alive.
Rowe has gone out with two fouls now. So Napier to play it in. Still Walker and Oriaki leading the way for Connecticut. Underdogs today, but hanging right in there throughout with the number two team in the country. Nice block by Green and a shot by Napier.
And a bad shot by Napier.
Lucius with Walker running out. Green in the right place. Michigan State by two.
By design, Sean, he passed and went to the weak side. Most shots end up usually hitting the rim and going long. Heady play by the big fella.
We talk about a lot of the players in this field committing to one school, going to another. Draymond Green originally committed to Kentucky, but decommitted when Tubby Smith left to go to Minnesota. Might play against the team he once thought he was going to play for. Michigan State and Kentucky pair up here tomorrow.
Maybe Jay and I could get you to decommit.
Who's never been recruited?
Bad pass. We're ignoring the two of you. Best we can.
Knowing where to go and being in the right spot. The big fella down the pump. And just reading it in a... Look at this now. I just love it. Understands where to be. Look at him. He becomes the guy checking out. Takes over. Dominates.
So Keith Appling, the freshman, at the line after the first foul of the game on Kemba Walker. Appling made the first. He was Mr. Basketball in Michigan last year. And a McDonald's All-American. We got off to a nice start at Michigan State. 14 points in his debut on only four shots against Eastern Michigan. That's the seventh highest point total ever by a Michigan State freshman in his first game.
Really got to pack it in right now and make sure that Kemba Walker is seeing a lot of white jerseys in his way. He's the big threat out there.
Lamb's long jumper rattled out. Austin Thornton back in with his three fouls, controlled the rebound. Now Michigan State trying to open up a little breathing room in a game that has been tight throughout.
Oh, what a play. That little curl play. He does finish beautifully, doesn't he?
Well, the guard just gets in there and sets that screen. It's pretty.
Green down to Sherman. And Michigan State with a six-point lead, the largest of the night for either team. They're on an 8-0 run.
Just hit the elbow, look at the back door, and the passer goes in and sets a little screen. Now, watch Corey Lucius when he hits Draymond Green. You're going to see the back door by number 13, Thornton, and then he sets a little brush screen for Garrick Sherman. Picks off Olander. Easy basket. That's really pretty. See the screen right there. Just catches Olander trailing, didn't jump to the ball, and you get a layup. That's pretty.
Gorgeous play. A lot of options on that.
ESPN is the home court of College Hoops Wednesday. ESPN2 has both semifinals from the Dick's Sporting Goods NIT season tip-off at 7 Eastern. Virginia Commonwealth takes on Scotty Hobson and number 24 Tennessee. And then at 9, Ben Hollins, UCF Bruins face 7th-ranked Villanova. The Dick's Sporting Goods NIT season tip-off, part of Feast Week, presented by Lowe's on ESPN2 Wednesday.
A young team defensively will break down, and the plays that Michigan State runs, you put a lot of pressure on you.
Important offensive trip for UConn.
And they get it in the right hands. Walker found Smith. He was open and nailed a three. Roscoe Smith.
This kid can deliver from deep.
He's also unafraid. He pulled that trigger quickly.
John McDonough, Jay Billis, Bill Raftery, our producer Aaron Stoikoff, our director Ken Dennis. Delighted to have you with us. Semifinal action from Maui and a deep three from Draymond Green.
Can't leave him.
15 for Green.
Nice.
Walker responds with a three.
Wow, pretty is that. The little fade off the screen and ready to shoot when he caught it. That was big time.
Did it feel like March, fellas?
Well, it was 2005 also out here.
Yeah.
These two teams were here. Michigan State played that great semifinal game, triple overtime loss to Gonzaga. And then Connecticut beat Gonzaga in the final on a buzzer beater by Denham Brown. Oh, he's feeling it. Draymond Green, and a junior from Saginaw, Michigan. Another three.
And, Sean, it's the rookie on him, Roscoe Smith. Sneaking peeks. They go a pick and pop, pick and slide. Can't cover him quick enough.
In the first half, Michigan State was getting good shots but not hitting them. They're hitting them this half.
Walker stuck in traffic. Roscoe Smith had it blocked by Green. 10 to shoot. Walker told Giffey to send it back out. Walker knows the situation. 5 to shoot. Has to shoot it. And makes it.
Woo. Wow. Big time.
It does feel like March, Bill. Great action here in late November at the EA Sports Maui Invitational. Thornton and an offensive foul, a moving screen. Called on Draymond Green. His second. That's about the only thing Green's done wrong lately. And when Connecticut has needed the answer, Walker has provided it. Well, great start to the year for the Big Ten. Indiana defeated, and as you saw, three Big Ten teams in the top eight in the country. Michigan State 2, Ohio State 3, Purdue number 8. They also have Minnesota and Illinois 17th and 19th respectively, and Wisconsin just fell out of the top 25. palming the ball. Napier's been doing that all day. You kind of wondered if they were eventually going to call it.
The mistake was he didn't pass the ball to Walker. They ran a double screen. Give it to him and let him make the decision.
Well, Napier better, I think, guys, change the way he dribbles the ball, because you and I have been gesturing at each other a couple times, Jay. He keeps palming the ball and getting away with it.
Well, it's been kind of a natural thing for him, but you're right. He needs to keep that hand on top of the ball because the referees call that in college.
Jay's been gesturing, but not over the palming.
Lucas. That's 10 points for Kalen. And the lead back to 6. 9 minutes to go. Michigan State the favorite to win the Big Ten. When we talked to Tom Izzo the other day about how tough the Big Ten is, he said, thanks for ruining my day. Some think it's the best conference in the country this year.
I do, by far.
Deeper than most.
Because right now, the Big East has more undefeated teams than any conference in America. Still 9 undefeated Big East teams, but then again, they have the most teams. They have 16 teams.
Well, Shabazz is really a confident player, though. I mean, even after that mistake, put it on the deck, gets to the rim, tries to make the floater.
Delvon Rowe called for his 3rd. 16 foul against State, so the next one puts them over the limit. And here's Shabazz Napier. Really benefited from playing with Kemba Walker. Kemba's been like a big brother to him. And Walker happy to help him. He thinks Napier's going to be a terrific player.
I do. He's going to have a great year, I think.
Special really defensive ability.
He changes the way they can play. They can play smaller if they want to. Play him on the ball. Let Walker be the 2-guard.
Jim Calhoun. Since Napier has a great understanding of the game, and he'd like him to dribble less.
Might want to look for Draymond Green. He's got Roscoe Smith guarding him again.
Whoa, for that logo at midcourt, it causes a lot of problems. We've seen a lot of players slipping over that big logo on the middle of the court.
It gets a little wet, almost like ice.
Tom Izzo saying it looked like he got tripped. And that was exactly what happened with Kalen Lucas, but Green just slipped.
Jay, you were
shuffled
saying
his feet a little bit.
How tenacious he is defensively, though. I mean, he rags people. Napier, real solid.
I mean, he's disruptive. Mm. You know, he get up underneath you, and he's got a great sense for getting steals. You know, if you have some sort of spin or inside hand change, he can get around, knock that ball away. He's gotten quite a few steals this year off doing that, taking it from good ball handlers.
Our crack statistician, Mike Swanson, who keeps track of everything, tells us another stat. At least a half a dozen players have slipped on that logo today at center court. Swanee's playing hurt for the injured left wrist, the required surgery. Outside, the Kentucky folks, and as always, they travel in a big pack. They're getting ready to come in and cheer on the blue against Washington.
That bad wrist hasn't hampered Swanee during the evening.
Swanee says he heard his wrist slipping on that logo, as a matter of fact. He's walked across the court.
Coming into the hotel.
Darrell Summers guarded by Niels Giffey.
Well, Green was wide open as the space guy after that double.
Delvon Rowe passed it out to Lucas. 8 to shoot for Michigan State. Good screen by Rowe. Has it back from Summers. They need a shot. They don't get it.
2 big trips. Good defense by UConn. I am really impressed, Jay, the way they've guarded. I don't think they guarded this well last year.
9th turnover for Tom Izzo's Michigan State Spartans. He's led Michigan State to the last 2 Final Four, 6 of the last 12. Just the 4th school in the history of NCAA basketball to go to 6 Final Fours in a 12-year span. Duke, North Carolina, and UCLA, the others.
Yeah, but every 4-year player has got a shot at a Final Four under him. That is incredible what he's been able to do.
Napier almost started to dribble too much for his coach's liking, and then found Walker and missed a deep 3. They've been a streaky 3-point shooting team today. Connecticut started out 3 for their first 14, then made 3 out of 4. Now for the game, 6 for 21.
Michigan State spreading it. They're going 4 around 1 with
run out ball screens.
Summers. Ooh, Walker. Giffey did travel and got away with it, and then Walker short on the layup, but Napier was there to poke it back to Walker for the uncontested layup.
And so what a heads up play by the little guy.
26 for Walker, below his season average of 30.3 per game. That's the best three-game start ever for a Connecticut player under Jim Calhoun at 30 points per game.
Well, Draymond Green is wide open. They're not looking for him.
Abley in trouble on the dribble, got it back to Green. His floater well short. Oriaki the rebound. And now a three could tie it for the underdog Huskies with under 7 minutes to go. Walker will spin into the lane.
Take it over. The other end, Roscoe Smith cannot play Draymond Green. He is really struggling against him, Jake.
But they're not looking for him. I mean, they got to start looking for him.
At one point yesterday, Kemba Walker scored 13 straight points for Connecticut to help lead them back. And he's leading them back again today. Michigan State by one with 6:34 to go.
How smooth has that kid been? Kemba, electrifying.
There's been a lot of talk about the best point guard in the country. I think you're looking at him right there.
It's got to be in the discussion.
Nobody's played better than this young man. 42 against Vermont, 29 in the second half against Wichita State, and against an excellent defense that has been geared to stop number 15. He's come through.
Have you ever seen more variety of scoring, though? I mean,
never. certainly not this year.
No, unbelievable the arsenal he possesses.
I'm talking to some of the scouts who are here, they love his leadership. He's really a charismatic player. One NBA scout I talked to today said, for this year's story, they kind of looked at him as maybe a backup point guard in the NBA, but now some of these NBA folks start to think he has a chance to be more than that.
Mm-hmm. You never reveal your sources, by the way.
Well, there's a lot of scouts here, so it's nice because you can talk to a lot of them and get a consensus.
Look at that hustle. Playing both ends.
Walker charging to the bucket. Got a finger on his miss, and then a foul called as Roscoe Smith went back up. And he's got to go to the line with a chance to give Connecticut a lead with 6:11 to go. Timeout. Washington Huskies moments ago arriving for their date with number 9 Kentucky. That'll be coming up right after our first EA Sports Maui Invitational semifinal of the day is complete. Kemba Walker has led UConn right back into it. And yesterday we spoke with Jim Calhoun about his star guard.
He doesn't have a problem with many things because he does the right things almost all the time. And by that I mean simply, when he wasn't a jump shooter when he came, he's got a very good jump shot now. When he in turn was trying to master how to become a good student, he mastered that. Took 17 hours in the summer, this past summer. Still went with the select team and did exceptionally well. I mean, those are the kind of things that we were talking before about why I love coaching, to watch guys attack things that way.
He has to be a joy to coach, and he's certainly fun to watch play. And not quite dominating the shot attempts as he had yesterday. A lot of help from Oriaki and Napier. This game is tied for the 15th time. On the free throw by Roscoe Smith.
Another young man who's done a very good job in this game. He's rebounded, knocked some open shots down.
Last foul was on Draymond Green, his third. And now we have our 9th lead change of the game. Two of the great programs in college basketball. And they're waging a memorable battle here in Maui today. Lucius had it rattle out, and flying into the bucket was Delvon Rowe. He's called for going over the back, and it's his fourth.
Quick jack.
And well, over the limit.
He didn't wait for the screen. Ball screen was coming to him. He just pulled the trigger. If he waits for the screen, he can come off and get something off of it.
Yeah, that's what these games are for, though. Straighten those things out. Make those adjustments as the year progresses and get ready for the NCAA.
Derek Sherman back in for Michigan State. 14 points and 13 rebounds today for Alex Oriaki. Whoa, a rock, but Giffey is there.
Giffey got away with a push.
He did. Little arm bar, as you would call it.
Holy cow, how do you miss that?
Nine straight points for Connecticut. They've come back to take a three-point lead with 5.5 to go.
Nice trail by Walker causes that deflection.
And the defense continues to be sensational for the Huskies. Napier, the lay-in. Great work by Walker at the defensive end to get it started.
He trailed and hugged the hip like coaches teach you. Made it a tough delivery.
This matches the largest Connecticut lead.
The younger team showing more poise.
Ooh.
And perhaps more energy with that extra rest that Tom Izzo was concerned about.
Ooh.
Played 6.5 hours earlier yesterday than did Connecticut. Oscar Smith didn't like the call. So it's nice to see a Connecticut team playing with this kind of youthful exuberance, because the last couple of years wasn't always a happy looking bunch.
That was the Tavern League discard on that free throw, but just great defense set up this run out. Yeah, they do seem compatible, don't they?
Mm-hmm. Well, it's a group that looks like they're having fun. They like each other. They're playing hard. Green made the free throw.
Talk about exuberance. Shabazz being the barrister there.
That was the same look Jay had hit on his face last night when you said you were picking up the tab.
I had a revival.
Oriaki working on Sherman. Under 5 minutes to go. A dandy here in Maui, and still Kentucky and Washington to come.
He's calling for a clear out here.
Walker. Air ball, battle for it, held ball, Sherman and Oriaki, and it'll stick with Connecticut with 9 seconds on the shot clock.
It's interesting, Walker may be a little fatigued. He settled for the jumper. He's got Green. Should have either called for the ball screen or just beaten him with the bounce.
Nine to shoot. Walker, a step back, very tough three. Couple of wild shots now from Kemba Walker. And a three would tie it for Michigan State. Lucas bumped by Napier.
Boy, that was some speed to get by. A quick feed to Napier.
Third foul on Napier, the fifth team foul, so it won't be a shooting opportunity here for the Spartans.
And Michigan State, we pointed out the fact that the Spartans have been a jump shooting team. They have not been able to get Connecticut into the 1-1 in the second half. They don't put them in a position to foul.
Green started a drive, pulled up, missed it. Summers again crashing. Green snatching. And he was fouled.
Well, he has some ticker, this kid.
Well, he's had a great game. And give Summers some credit for keeping that ball alive. It's up by Summers was the one that kept it alive, and Green, that's his 10th, 11th rebound, I think. He's got 18, but he's scratched in every category.
He loves to get in there and compete, too, and be physical.
Back-to-back double-doubles here in Maui, and that's three in a row because he had 18 and 12 in their home game against South Carolina before he came over here. 11 career double-doubles now for the junior from Saginaw.
He's got those four assists, a couple of blocks. He's got a steal. He's done everything.
Physically, reminds you a little of Elton Brand?
A little bit, but
not as tall.
Nowhere near as big.
That's the first free throw missed by Michigan State. 14 out of 15, but they'll keep it as it was last touched by UConn.
Derek Sherman really worked hard to get in and rebound from that second slot.
Ooh.
Tough catch, but Draymond Green did that as well.
And Napier has done a great job defensively.
Lucas brings it out, plenty of time on the shot clock.
Well, Green loves to use his experience.
Now 15 to shoot.
Nice.
Green into Sherman, little turnaround shot. ties up the game for the Spartans.
That's the point forward mentality of Draymond Green. It's terrific delivery, Jake.
Nice little two-man game, and Sherman has got terrific hands, doesn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Michigan State and Connecticut tied for the 16th time. Tough pass. Napier very close to Oriaki.
Lucius is hurt.
The ball was last touched by Michigan State. It'll be Connecticut's ball when we come back with 3:20 to go.
Little two-man game between Garrick Sherman and Draymond Green, and the nice little jump hook by the big guy.
This 27th EA Sports Maui Invitational, the winner of this one against either Kentucky or Washington. That's the game coming up next on ESPN. Later tonight on ESPN2, about an hour from now, Duke and Kansas State in the CBE Classic Final presented by O'Reilly Auto Parts. The number one and number four team in the country so far.
Mm-hmm.
Sit in front of that TV, get the remote control ready to go, back and forth. Duke and K-State and Kentucky and Washington. Doesn't get any better than that if you're a college hoops fan tonight.
Pretty darn good. And now coming down the stretch, a little experience now. Walker, a guy that's going to make a lot of decisions on the other one end, and Draymond Green has stepped up magnificently down the stretch.
Still have to watch Walker here taking the ball out of bounds underneath. Oftentimes it's the inbounder that you're looking for on the play.
17 seconds to shoot for Connecticut as they play it in. Moriaki out to Napier. And now Walker, Roscoe Smith, and Jeremy Lamb also on the court for UConn. And a turnover as Walker lost it. 9 Connecticut turnovers, and now a chance to reclaim the lead for Michigan State with 3 minutes to go.
All that rotating on Walker might be wearing. He's done some different things down the stretch here. A couple of tough jacks in that play.
Get it to the other side.
Green Sherman. Down Sherman in the lane. And it's last touched by Connecticut. 10 seconds to shoot for Michigan State.
Sherman's so smart, Jay. He created that passing lane.
And he knows that Green has the vision to find him. Mm-hmm. You get open, he'll find you.
They switch basketballs again. Very warm and humid in the building.
Gotta watch Green here. Look.
Duck in.
5 to shoot. Summers. The dump down, and Green is fouled. 3 Huskies converged.
But they have found the answer. Just let the big fella touch it down on that block. He has been available and steps up whenever he has to.
But what made it? It's the penetration.
Mm-hmm.
You got a great athlete in Darrell Summers that can put the ball on the deck and punch the lane more often than he does it.
Well, they're 14 out of 16 from the line now, and both misses from Draymond Green. As you saw in the graphic, a 67% free throw shooter last year. For a 1-point lead. 10th lead change of the game.
Moriaki has not had a touch. Maybe get him a little bit involved. Get him interested.
I say go to Walker and let Oriaki clean it up.
Yeah, they tried to.
Walker just did save it for Giffey. Now Napier. Long rebound. And poked toward the sideline. Looked like Walker was the last to touch, and that's what Tim Higgins says. It'll be Michigan State's ball. Jim Calhoun doesn't like it. It was close to him, but from our vantage point across the court, it looked to me like Walker was the last to touch. Yep.
Look at Jimmy. He's looking for some help, assistance from anybody.
Whoa, another slip near that logo by Summers as he passed off. And a hold called on Napier. I don't think these freshmen for Connecticut are going to get away all year long with being as verbal toward the officials and demonstrative as they've been allowed to be today. That's the 4th foul now on Napier. And a 1-and-1 opportunity with 2 minutes to go for Kalen Lucas. A rare miss from Lucas. He's made 382 career free throws. That's seventh all time at Michigan State. Inside, nice offense, but then Oriaki missed a short one.
Well, he went to that left hander, it slipped. Either one. He's done the same little plays earlier. Back screen on the elbow.
Appling, the freshman, tough fadeaway. Rebound by Oriaki. A chance for a Connecticut lead with under a minute and a half to go. Trying to pull off an upset over the number two team in the country. Walker. Oh, they're going to call a foul before the walk because clearly he traveled if he had not been pushed first, and the foul is on Appling, the freshman.
Yeah, I admire what he's trying to do, take over. He gets a little split here. But some down screens, maybe get a ball reversal and then give it to him, Jay. Tough one you can identify early in the offense.
Three fouls on Appling. This is the last 1-1 for Connecticut, the 19th foul against Michigan State. Walker 77% last year from the line. That looked like a tired free throw. Well long, but it wound up with Giffey.
And Michigan State is right there for the rebound, but they're not finishing it off by grabbing the ball.
1 minute to go. Walker, does he have it left in the tank? Another tough shot. Woo! He made it.
Woo! Wow. Reaching back into his tricks.
30 again for Walker. 103 points in the last three games for Kemba Walker. Timeout, Spartans. Down by a point with 47 and a half to go.
Everybody knows he's gonna take it, and he's still able to raise that level of play. Goodness.
When it comes down to grabbing a loose ball, this offense, this rebound goes a little long. It is UConn that comes away with it, and that sets up Kemba Walker.
Mm. And how about this one? Some early onions in Maui. Wow.
A much improved shooting stroke. It is much more reliable.
When we talk about all the work that he did over the summer, you have to be in phenomenal shape to play in this heat and humidity. And you can see again, they're spending extra time doing every timeout, wiping off that logo at center court. You wonder, because there, as you said, Bill, a little while ago, a couple shots were way off, a couple sloppy plays by Walker. He missed the free throw badly. Looked like fatigue might be setting in, and then that shot.
So much for my analysis, basically. You know, it amazes me. The preparation is all about him by Michigan State. And yet he's able to raise his level and come up big.
He has just been phenomenal. There hasn't been anybody better in college basketball in this early season than Kemba Walker. And the difference in the game thus far with UConn leading is they've got Kemba Walker and Michigan State doesn't.
Mm-hmm.
42 against Vermont, 31 yesterday, and 30 today from a player who averaged 14 and a half points per game last season with more veteran scoring help around him. Guys like Jerome Dyson, Stanley Robinson. Coming up next, basketball scoreboard, followed by semifinal action. Game number two from here at the EA Sports Maui Invitational. Tough act to follow for Kentucky and Washington, but they are two of the very best teams in the country.
Got to come through green. Wow.
For the lead. Well off from Kalen Lucas. Rebound Oriaki, and he was fouled.
I believe that was a post-up for Draymond Green. And the quick jack. He was setting his guy up in the low post area.
Delvon Rowe just fouled out.
Jay, check this out now. Here's the dribble handoff. He gets himself right in position to dominate. And the quick jack, he can't even get a touch. You know he's going to find somebody or finish it himself.
So Rowe fouls out. It's also the 10th team foul, so it's a double bonus the rest of the way.
Right now, a free throw blockout becomes gigantic. Oriaki, not a good free throw shooter. And that ball, you can expect it to come off a little hard.
Oriaki was just 54% from the free throw line last season, and he's 0-for-2 from the line today. But he'll have two shots, 14 points, and 16 rebounds. for another guy who looks to be much improved over a year ago, his freshman season.
He's a guy that can get the ball down in the box and do some damage. Haven't had that.
Oh, what a friendly bounce. Woo.
You get it down with that one.
Like his gesture. He had it all the way, never in doubt. For a three-point lead now. Long again. Giffey a couple of tips. And it went out of bounds. Boy, he does a nice job at getting in good position of that offensive glass on the free throw.
And they will concentrate as the year goes on to make sure they squeeze him. Good reaction.
So now two to tie, three for the lead for Michigan State, in just fractions the difference between the game clock and the shot clock. They're not going to go deep into the clock as Green was fouled as he turned to face up.
That's what they wanted earlier. Let him be the decision maker. He is a stud down in that box area.
So now Green with 22 points today. 6 of 8 from the line. Eleven rebounds for Draymond, too, and that's a rock. And Jim Calhoun wants and has granted the timeout. One timeout left for each team. Draymond Green has missed three of his last four, frustrated.
Plenty of time, too, depending on what he does, how you want to play it. Get your defense set.
Well, the most important thing for UConn is make or miss getting the ball into the hands of a handler and a good free throw shooter, because you're going to get fouled.
Face guard everybody. Hopefully Oriaki comes to help out. That would be an ideal. Don't let Walker particularly touch it.
Well, there have been some key plays down the stretch. Kemba and Make missed the free throw, but Giffey tracked it down, and it led to the biggest shot of the game so far.
It's amazing how important those free throw blockouts are.
Michigan State made their first 14 free throws of the game. They're 1 for 5 since. Three of those four misses from Draymond Green, the other one from Kalen Lucas. Green has one more chance to make it a one-point game. And unlucky there. It was in and out, and then a foul on the rebound.
You got the right guy, though.
Yeah, Oriaki was fouled. His 17th rebound. He had 18 rebounds in their opener against Stony Brook. It's not even a season high for him with 18 rebounds today.
I think both of these guys have to be pleased the way their team has played, though. I mean, they just, the level has been extremely high for this early in the year.
Foul is on Sherman, his second. Again, two shots for Oriaki. He makes both. It would be a two-possession game. Huge free throws for the sophomore.
Seems to come on that left side frequently, doesn't it, Jerry? Shoots it right to left.
A little bit. Even if this goes in, you don't have to take a three.
That's long and way off. Long and left, didn't get the friendly bounce. Two to tie, three for the lead for Michigan State. 14 seconds to go. They have a timeout. Lucas, the Big Ten player of the year, has it back from Lucius.
Oh!
Threw it behind Summers. Boy, Gibby went diving for it as if he thought it was deflected by Connecticut. And if he had touched that, it might have been a disaster for the Huskies. 3.3 to go. Spartans need to be attentive here and go for the quick steal or very quick foul.
Pretty good play by Napier. Napier, good cut. Got to get somebody going to the basket. Too many people bound here for Connecticut.
You don't want to throw it toward Michigan State's basket if you can help it.
Giffey playing it in.
They got a hold right here. Yep.
Summers.
So they'll send Napier to the line.
A little back cut. Ooh,
boy, he went after it to try to.
Oh, he may have gotten a piece of it.
He touched that ball.
Yeah, it looked like he did.
He had a feel it was a deflection. Otherwise, why would he?
Maybe he deflected it.
Ooh. That should have been Michigan State's ball. So now the freshman Napier with two shots. One out of two from the line today. That hops out. So still a hope for Michigan State.
Well, if he misses this, get a rebound.
It looks like Tom's going to call timeout. I just saw him signal on the shot.
Well, you have to if he misses it.
Yeah.
Wonder about fatigue again.
Well, you don't miss this on purpose, do you?
No, I make it a three. You know what happens in this crazy game.
Connecticut's one for the last seven from the line. He made it. Yeah, why wouldn't you make it? Get ahead by three, then even if they throw in some sort of miraculous three, they can't beat you.
No, true. But the point is, if you miss it, that's an awfully long way to go in 2 seconds. And well, you do have a timeout. But what I'm saying is, a little time would go off. Now they've got 2.3 seconds, can run the baseline, and you get a chance to set
up.
You'd
rather have the three-point lead.
I'd rather have the three-point lead. Yeah, but it's kind of the issue that you had in the national championship game between Duke and Butler.
Did you see Duke Butler? I was just going to say the same thing. Amazing, they got that shot off.
So now the strategy for Michigan State.
Well,
need a three.
Yeah, that was their last timeout, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know, that hurts in a way because you can't get it to half court and do some damage. So now it's got to be some sort of a back screen on one side, a post up, and a kick deep. I mean, there's not room to do too much.
I think you want to try to throw it long into the middle of the floor. You're likely to be able to catch the ball, and if you've got cutters going on both sides, you've got a chance to dump it off.
Now, Connecticut is a young team. Do they foul before they can shoot a three?
You can, but that's why I'm saying throw it long. Mm-hmm. If you try to do anything else, you'll put yourself. But the problem is, you try to foul and somebody gets in their shooting motion, it's three free throws.
Yeah. The two teams have combined to make only three of the last 14 free throws. It's blocked out of bounds by Smith, but it did take 0.3 seconds off the clock.
And now also everybody knows what they're running. So Connecticut, Green had come up on a back screen. Now they're just going to have a wild shot.
Green from half court lets it go. Just missed. And Connecticut has upset number two, Michigan State. Walker surrounded by a young cast of Huskies, picked by the Big East coaches to finish 10th in the conference this year. They are 4-0 with a big notch on their belt as they take down Michigan State, the preseason favorites to win the Big Ten and the number two team in the country. And Bill, given the circumstances, about a pretty good look.
They were trying to foul him.
Yeah,
right in front of Jim Calhoun. Unbelievable opportunity there. Watch this. There's the giveaway and not called. And this is one of those you dodge.
Yeah,
just great.
An uncontested half court shot.
Yeah, for a guy that strong with that kind of ability.
Where's Jay? He's with Jim Calhoun.
You know, Jim, against Wichita State, you looked like you had a young team. They looked a lot older against Michigan State, and your defense was phenomenal.
Yeah, we seemed to grow up an awful lot, Jay. And I think we started to get over screens, and you know, kids are complaining that the officials weren't calling them. Well, Tommy's teams roll that screen down so quick, it's probably not a foul, but you're going to fight your way through it. And I thought we really did a great job defensively.
And there was one other difference. You had Kemba Walker, and they didn't.
Kind of like that, yeah. I'm becoming a genius very quickly in offense. Kemba, you take it this side. Kemba, you take it that side. But no, and I think the great thing is our team's aware of who he is. Where some teams aren't aware of great players, he's a great player, and they're very aware of who he is.
Well, congratulations on another step toward a championship here in Maui.
Thank you very much.
Let's get Kemba Walker in here. Kemba, just an extraordinary performance with so many young players. What were you talking about during the course of this game, having a chance to win it toward the end?
You know, I just told the guys to stay solid, especially Shabazz. You know, he's one of the guys who gamble a lot, but, you know, I just asked him to stay solid on defense, and, you know, we was fortunate enough to come out with this victory.
What was your emotion like at the end of the game, having won against the number two team in the country? You seemed like you were very excited.
Very excited. You know, first of all, just you know, getting revenge on them from the Final Four my freshman year. And, you know, just beating the number two team in the country. That's exciting, especially everybody keeps saying that we're a young team. So, you know, we showed the world that we can play.
Well, congratulations on another great performance. Good luck in the title game.
I appreciate it.
They're showing the world it might be a better than anticipated season in the great Nutmeg State. 30 points, 4 assists for Kemba Walker. And coming up next, Terrence Jones, the brilliant freshman of Kentucky, against Isaiah Thomas. Another one of the great guards in America. That'll be semifinal number 2, Kentucky and Washington, the winner to get Connecticut, which got 15 points and 17 rebounds from Alex Oriaki tonight. Final score, UConn 70 and Michigan State 67. College basketball scoreboard next over on ESPN2 at 10 Eastern Time, Duke and Kansas State. We're back shortly with more great action from Maui. Aloha! Here's Carl Ravitch in the studio.